Mmeamkaje?
Vizuri.
Yesterday was World Swahili Day, and even as Uganda moves to adopt the language that is spoken in most of East Africa, there is still a lot of work to do. Kiswahili is being sold as the business language that is the icing on the cake for East African integration. It is therefore urgent that Ugandans get with the program. Learn the language. Our reporter Juliet Namwaya asked a few wananchi what they think about learning the language and how much they can speak. For many, at least five words. Habari, Muzuri, the most common.
There, when I was still in school, I'll be knowing Swahili right now. It would be easier for me to communicate to my clients in Swahili, because sometimes it gives me hard time to communicate to a Congolese, to a Kenyan, to a Tanzanian.
Swahili, I know. I can talk about my business. Mimi uko mkubwa, nasuka nywele ya wasichana.
Ongea Kiswahili, nilikuwa kwa shule. Wakitufundisha Swahili na mimi nika pick kila kitu kile wanatuambiaka.
This time I'm glad that the government has implemented the Swahili language to make it official.
In Uganda, very few people speak Swahili. In fact, it is relegated to men in uniform, a kind of layer of hardness, rough around the edges enough to sharpen authority and order. We are talking soldiers, the police, and Uganda prisons. This week, East African Affairs Minister Rebecca Kadaga announced that in 3 to 4 years, the language will be examinable in the primary leaving examinations and will be made a compulsory subject alongside English, both as official languages.
Due to meet with the Minister of Gender Education, so that we work out a plan. We now have at least one teacher for primary school. There are not enough to teach all the classes, but there's at least one we can post to each school. But we need at least 7 for each school. So we are going to roll out a plan, and in about 3-4 years, we shall make Swahili compulsory at PLE, so that children are taking English, Swahili, science, SST, mathematics. So when we start with that, we shall have children who have more than one language.
Work with the youth, specifically the youth. I can see a lot of youth around to take up this language, be keen and interested to learn the language. Uganda is one of the countries. We have so many Swahili teachers in the country. Once we promote it, also our business community will benefit from it.
She had also intimated that members of the cabinet are currently taking Kiswahili lessons and that by the end of the year, cabinet meetings will be conducted in Kiswahili.
The plan is to engage next the immigration officers, because they work at the borders with the population, the revenue people, because they always deal with people who are moving back and forth. All those who work at the borders will be my next target. And then we shall deal with the health workers, because they treat people. And so on. So all those that deal with the public, we shall work out a plan.
Although the education ministry is still struggling to get qualified teachers to teach Kiswahili, it has promised that for starters, at least 7 teachers will be provided per school. English has been Uganda's only official language since independence in 1962. Kiswahili was proposed as the second official language in 2005, but it was only taught as an optional subject. Until last year, when cabinet recommended that teaching of Kiswahili be made compulsory in primary and secondary schools. Report by Juliet Namwaya for the news.